So we used to get technology people into HR and we used to ask them to run. So he said, I want a couple of technology people in Bangalore also to start investing along with me in TCS. So shall we call Chax, E.S. Chakravarti. So I met him. Sir, I'm a C++ architect. 2002, I'm the C++ architect of TCS Bangalore working for Bell Labs in California. I came back and said, I'm a C++ architecture. What makes you to see HR competencies in me? And you are offering me HR role. And the first role I played is Economic Relationship Manager under TAG of HR. He said, Chax, to become an HR professional, I don't need people with MBA HR degree. I need a person who is a good human being. Sir, what makes you think that I'm a good human being? He said, one value system of Tata's, respect for people. I'm bold. I joined HR. One statement of selling that happened to me in 2003 to start offering my services to TCS in HR. Normally people don't try it. From a C++ architect to HR, have you ever seen those kind of combinations? One statement, he bowled me. And now today he is the CEO of Tata Powered, okay? And what I am today is because of him in HR. So what exactly is respect for human beings? Respect for humans, the colleagues, respect for their ideas, respect for teamwork, respect for somebody else's performance, respect for our elders. And this is the true value system of Tata's and TCS, which made Tata's and TCS the most respected organizations in this country, not our business, our value system. So the culture of respecting people, the culture of respecting competition, the culture of respecting your colleagues, the culture of respecting colleagues' ideas, and the culture of accepting others' best practices in spite of a tough competition. And this is what is culture of respect. So boys and girls, there are plenty of things that we can do, but trust me, I got to know Sir Ratan Tata was here a couple of months back or a year back, and he was in BVB Hubli, and I also got an opportunity to meet him a couple of times. He never spoke language of business. He always spoke the language of a human being. And that made him the true icon of corporate houses in this country. Do you agree with me? So put your hands together for that wonderful gentleman. I think that is what is the culture I spoke about today. And I'm sure Gen Y wants to build the right culture for themselves. And Gen Y have dreams that they want to achieve in their life. And Gen Y comes with a phenomenal potential which we never had in the past because of various reasons. I think you take competencies and culture very seriously, and seeing academia very closely for the last 1.5 decade, I know TAPME gives you the right platform of nurturing both competencies and the culture to all of you. And I am promising on behalf of them that this institute definitely will give the platform for both of these two. 5 minutes. Before I go to the next two sets of important people sitting on the dais and off the dais, now I spoke like a corporate guy, but let me talk like a small or a senior person for you. In fact, I used to be the visiting faculty for MIT Manipal for 3 years, 2004 to 2007. I used to teach software engineering in MIT Manipal. And my guru is still there in MIT Manipal, KJ Kamat sir, one of the most trusted academicians that we have ever met in the academic industry. So, as a friend, as a senior of Manipal, Sir Manipal, I also, admire it. And whenever I came to Manipal, something good happened to me in TCS also. Okay, so Manipal is a place of luck for me too. As a friend, as a senior person, what is that I can give you? 2-3 tips. Number one, boys and girls, wherever you go, never ever compromise on the value system that we are known for. This country, our families, our parents, our academic institutions, our society is made of values. Never ever compromise on the value system. And number two, I'm sure TAPME gives you phenomenal, opportunities. You will become very wealthy after 1 decade or 2 decades of your professional life. but never ever forget to contribute something back to the society we belong to. This society has given an enormous amount of things for us. Never ever forget to give something back to the society and community that we belong to. And number three, which is a big, big issue for me in TCS as head of operations. I have 42,000 people in TCS Bangalore, which I head. The second largest delivery center for TCS. The biggest problem I have in TCS Bangalore is safety of my people. I never had incidents within the compound walls of TCS. I always had issues outside the compound wall of TCS, especially two-wheeler accidents, four-wheeler accidents. In the craziness of flexibility, in the craziness of openness, in the craziness of what is it, no, young Gen Y nature, we end up in doing a lot of nice things, which brings excitement to you, but please do understand that that should not leave a kind of heartburn for many people who are looking at you as a future for themselves, especially your father and mother. Wherever you go, keep yourself safe and secured. With this, boys and girls, thank you so much for giving me a wonderful opportunity. It's a pleasure to say hi to all of you today, and I wish you all the best, and TCS is there to take care of you. And two more group of people, I'll take a couple of minutes and close it. The second important community, I spoke to students, I want to speak to the lecturers of TAPME. Sir, the staff of TAPME, what we are here in TCS today is because of you. TCS is 3 lakh people today, and all these people came from one engineering institute or one B school across the globe. So you guys are the architects of what the global workforce, what we have in TCS. Thank you so much, sir, for grooming so much of young talent in this country and ensuring that, you know, companies like us have grown because of having these people in our premises. 90% of our success is for you. Rest of the 10%, yes, we'll take our and pat our back. Why can't we give a big, big round of appreciation for every academician that we have in this country who made us what we are today at TCS Bangalore, both professionally and personally. And the last group of people, parents. Oh, they're smiling all over the place. I can see a couple of parents here. Lot of, what is it, you know, emotions and satisfaction and happiness that, yes, my son or daughter has done something today to get an admission into TAPME. Sir, and madam, all this while, we control them as parents, but let's start playing a new roles, which I also discovered very recently after having these two little kids at my home. Instead of controlling them, coach them. Instead of controlling them, mentor them. Instead of controlling them, guide them. Trust me, you will automatically become the remote controller for them. It's just the way how you structure the way we all give gyan. If they see a mentor, if they see a coach, if they see a guide, I'm sure the remote of our kids is in our hand. We need to give them that extra cushion of positioning ourselves as the three titles I said. And you have very young and bright and talented kids. I wish you all the best, and I'm sure, just like my dad, you also feel that you are the most luckiest parents of the earth because they did something today. Thank you so much. Have a fantastic time.
And thank you, Mr. Chakravarti, for your inspiring speech. As a token of respect, I request our director to hand over the memento to the chief guest. I now request Professor Gurraj Kidur, Dean Academics, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Respected members on the dais, my faculty and staff colleagues from TAPME, incoming students, parents and guardians of students, a very good morning to you all. There is a saying in English, all's well that ends well. Though there are different versions of that, as far as lectures are concerned, students seem to think, all's well that ends. I have my own version. I would say, all's well that begins well. And it is my proud privilege to offer a vote of thanks to people who have given an excellent start to TAPMI's PGDM program of 2014 and 16. First of all, I would like to thank Mr. E.S. Chakravarti, head of TCS Bangalore, for taking his time out and to enlighten the incoming batch about opportunities, trends, and the challenges, and reinforcing their self-confidence. Thank you very much, sir. And I am sure our students are raring to go. And thanks for those words of appreciation for faculty. Though we are little concerned about receiving fees in mobile minutes. Coming to mobiles, let me also tell you, we have banned mobiles only in classrooms, and that makes up 80% of our built-up area. I would like to thank Dr. Shantaram, trustee and member of TAPMI Governing Council, for presiding over the function. Our students will benefit by learning about Manipal, its history, and about people who made it what it is today. I'm sure, though they are strangers now, they will go out as ambassadors of Manipal and TAPMI after 2 years. Many of you would find it hard to believe that 50 years ago, wild animals roamed around in this area. Let me tell you, the central part of Manipal is still called as Tiger Circle. Thank you, Dr. R.C. Natarajan, Director TAPMI, for all your support. Your welcome speech would have surely excited the new batch. I'm sure of that. I would like to thank TAPMI faculty and staff for all their cooperation and support in making this event a success. Special thanks to the PGP Chair, Dr. Prashant Yadgiri, for his coordination. Administration staff, Mr. Nayak, Mr. Anand Fai, and their team have been working relentlessly for the last 2 days to make things happen here. A big thank you to them. PGP2 students, especially from Student Executive Council and Welfare Committee, have ensured that the incoming batch settles down smoothly. They deserve a mention here, and I thank them for the excellent work. I also thank the IT support team who ensured fail-proof functioning of the audio-video facilities. Last but not the least, I thank the parents and guardians of the students of the incoming batch for choosing TAPMI as the place for their sons, daughters to pursue their management studies. We will definitely live up to keep the faith that you have reposed on us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Guraj. I request Nivedita to present the memento to Mr. Sarfaraz Nawaz Khan, the campus recruitment lead, Karnataka. We now come to the end of the inaugural ceremony of the induction program of the new batch. Once again, thanking all the dignitaries on the dais, off the dais, and all the guests in the audience for making it up to the function. The induction session will now continue with more focus on the students, and we would require all the students to be present in the hall. Don't move out. Tea and snacks are arranged for the parents outside the hall. I request all the parents to kindly move for tea and snacks and join again for lunch, which is arranged in the same venue. Thank you.